3, 2. Oh, we already started.
Yeah, we're live, Reggie. Oh, okay. Yeah. Rams, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Yeah. Oh.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You know, it's so nice that we actually have chairs now.
That's pretty true. You know what? All that standing around, you know.
Yeah, it's just nice terrible.
Yeah,
well, you know what? I don't see any point wasting time. So let's just let's get right into the video. I mean, the announcements.
Sure, Reggie. Whatever you say. So, unified partners in need. We need unified partners for our season to happen. Let Miss Smith know ASAP if you are interested in helping us out. If we don't get any partners, our season is canceled. So if you have any wish to join, please let Miss Smith know.
RHS spring testing the SBA is coming up in just a few weeks now. And, well, just make sure to check what room you are, what your schedule is, and be prepared.
Ask your teacher for any questions you might have.
Yep.
Pacific Islander Club, Wednesday, March 30th, where room 102, Miss Kim's classroom, time from 3 to 4 p.m. All students welcome.
Wow, nice. Murph's Barbecue and Catering, hiring for Washington State Fair. Come join our team for the 53rd year at the fair. All the dates are listed below, which is April 14th through 16th. Hours are on Thursday 10:30 to 9:30, Friday 10:30 to 10:30, Saturday 9:30 to 10:30, and Sunday 9:30 to 9:30. Experience the fair in a whole new way. We work hard, but the work is done, and we play hard too.
Heritage concession stand hiring. Business hours are from the weekdays 4:30 to 9:00, weekends 10 to 6:00. Starting wage is $15 plus any tips you might get. Must have reliable transportation and communicate well. Like to smell fresh popcorn? Well, want to work with public? Want to have fun and earn money? Then this job is for you. Contact us at the email provided right there.
Snoopy! Hey, oh, guys. Hey. Hey, guys, you should really go see Snoopy. It's really good. Go see Snoopy. It's this weekend, April 1st and 2nd at 7 p.m. Go watch it. It's really, really good. The 31st.
Yeah, you can also watch it. I support this message.
Yeah.
So, attention junior and senior Rams. Are you interested in earning credit for working while in high school? Reach out to Miss Livernash, our on-time graduate specialist, at the email provided, or your counselor for details and for the required form.
Congratulations to the Elite 10, not the Elite 8, the Elite 10. Please remember, all classes are still upped for the most donated win as well. You can focus on bringing in clothes or hygiene items this week, but food is always welcome.
Go Rams. And we have seniors. Use this code below to sign up for Decision Day 2022. It is May 3rd, and scan the QR code if you are interested, and stop by room 103. And talk to Miss Pancake if you have any questions.
We'll leave this up. We will leave this up for a few more seconds just so that you can scan this QR code. Okay. Character strong. Thought of the day. This week's focus is well-being habits. We are what we repeatedly do. Excellence, then, is not an act, but a habit. Will Durant, writer, historian, and philosopher.
Some pretty cool stuff.
Yeah. The GSA, the first meeting of the Gender Sexuality Alliance Club, is on April 5th, which is, next Tuesday, in room 212 in Miss Hallberg's room from 3 to 3:30 p.m. Everybody is welcome. And just, if you want to join the Schoology group, then the QR, not the QR code, the code is right below. I'd really recommend going. Really nice.
So what's happening today, Monday the 28th? We have a boys baseball game at 4 away at GK and a girls fast pitch at 4 away at Curtis. Not much, but it's something, you know.
Yeah. Well, that about brings us to the end of the announcements part. So we got some banger videos coming up today. should definitely stick around to check him out. So,
you know what? I think with that, Rams, I think we should go.
Yeah.
All right.
Make sure to like and subscribe.
He's dead. We check his pockets.
Reggie,
legends never die.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Reggie and Reggie
Power Hour. Episode 2, by the way.
This week we're talking about Legends Never Die, which...
everyone's favorite sad boy.
Yeah, Juice WRLD. Rest in peace.
We're thinking, what's like a good way to like really get our thoughts across on
this album? What's the best way to go in-depth on songs instead of just spending 5 seconds on each one?
Yeah, so we're gonna do the Reggie and Reggie Big 3. Reggie, what's your Big 3 off this album?
I'm gonna start in third place is, honestly, Wishing Well. I think the song was really good. Like, I feel like the build-up to... like the instrumental buildup is really well done, and then how the song just has a lot of deep messages, and it has a lot of things about depression and anxiety that I relate to me all too well.
Okay.
And it's just a really, really well done song.
That's fair. All right, what's your second?
My second? Fighting Demons.
Oh yeah, for sure.
No, yeah,
for sure.
Fighting Demons is it's a masterpiece of a song. Sure. It's catchy, but also the chorus is just lifts my soul into the sky. It's perfect. I don't know.
It's funny you say that because Fighting Demons is also my number 2 selection.
Oh, so, really?
You know, us being, you know, Reggie's and everything, we tend to have the same like.
Yeah, Reggie is one entity that we both share.
Oh yeah, the resemblance is uncanny too. It's just,
I mean, we're both tall. Yeah. I mean, I'm weak and you're strong, but that's not important.
Anyway, what's your number one?
My number one, Come and Go.
Come and Go?
It's a bop. Like, it's not even, like, that much lyrically impactful. It's just a freaking bop. Okay. It doesn't get repetitive. It's just catchy and, honestly, perfection.
Okay, now, my Big 3.
Okay, I'm ready to tell you how wrong you are.
Number 3 is Come and Go. Marshmello, I like to call him the guy from Fortnite.
The guy from Fortnite.
The guy from Fortnite.
Right.
It's a good song. It's a good, like, implement of Marshmello style and Juice's style.
Yeah.
So, you kind of get the best of both worlds, again, the guy from Fortnite. Number 2, like I said, is Fighting Demons.
Fighting Demons.
Like you said, this is like the whole, like, chill, like, vibey kind of... era of this one, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then we're gonna go number 1. My number 1. Reggie hasn't even said it yet. It's kind of an underrated song, I think, is Righteous.
Righteous.
I love Righteous so much. It's so deep. It's just like a chill, like, vibey song. You can turn it on, like, at 3 a.m. when you're driving and just driving.
Yeah, Righteous. It's a great song. I'm not going to bash you for being number 1. It's like number 5 or 6. It's great.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, whole album, before we get into all the other songs. So out of 5.
Out of 5. We're going to put this on the table. 5 out of 5.
5?
Yeah. I love this album to death.
Okay. Unlike our last episode with Sour, Reggie Roberts himself is a Juice WRLD enjoyer. So I'll give it a 4.
Confession, I've listened to this album at least like 40 times, but it's still the only Juice WRLD album I've listened to.
There's a door. You're done.
Okay. Now is the favorite part where we are just going to speed through. Enjoy
speed run.
Enjoy this coconut mall.
You just got coconut mall.
You're gonna. Titanic.
It's sinking.
It's sinking?
I'll give it like a 9.
9?
You agree with me?
I agree.
Yeah, yeah. Reggie.
You're done.
You're done.
You're done. Ooh, Bori Kong has texted you. Oh, LMAO.
My personal space has been invaded by Reggie.
I don't know what you're talking
about. I don't even know what's going on.
That's terrible. I'm gonna cut that out.
That's staying in.
No, it's not. Yeah, I don't know how much of this like speedy is gonna get into the final cut because we gotta keep it in like what, 4 minutes?
Reggie's a master editor, so
I am.
We'll see how it goes.
Yeah, I'm a whiz.
And we don't
have any whizness. I'm a whiz.
We don't have any lemons this time around.
No lemons.
So I can't bite into anything. But we'll conclude this episode.
You have a shoe you can bite into.
We'll conclude this episode of the Reggie and Reggie Power Hour. I'm Reggie.
I'm also Reggie with a shoe.
And we'll see you on the next one.
See ya.
Bye.
We are back with our second round puzzle. We got our four contestants. We got four puzzles. Here we go. Puzzle makers, are you ready?
Yes.
Yeah. On your mark. Get set. Go!
Right into it. Philip is making a very strange round. What you got going on here, bro?
Get right down next to him and what's your strategy?
Hey, Philip, what's your strategy, man?
Study film. Get ready for this.
Does it look like it?
Come on.
Here we go.
Let's go.
Bill Kabeski. Albuquerque.
What you got going on here? What's your strategy?
Use the banana.
Yeah. Throw all your pieces into the box.
Yeah.
Oh.
All right, this is Adam Acevedo of 6th Period Video Production 1, and yeah, I'm ready to go.
Come on, let's see.
Remember Kinder Care.
What is your strategy here?
It's something. How do you say
something?
Yeah. Tori Madsen, Ridgecrest Elementary.
I know he's gonna win.
What is your strategy here?
I'm just trying to like find like the corners, the outer corners. Yeah.
Good idea.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Rami. Mickey Mouse Playhouse University.
Got something
going on.
Oh, we got a new technique over here. I like it.
It does need to be in the box.
Oh, it has to be in the box. Yeah.
Oh, it doesn't look like a ram. Oh,
good. Tori's moving in the right direction.
Come on.
You guys can do it.
Think about the ram.
I am thinking about it.
Colby, as previous winner, what are they doing wrong?
They're not looking at the colors.
I know.
Patterns, people. You gotta look for patterns.
My grandfather
told
me
in a business
that
sells.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, what's going on? Nice. This is my secret track. You'll see.
Oh, he's stuck. Oh. He's stuck.
Oh, I'm stuck too.
On every side.
I only got like this.
On every side.
Yeah.